Coffee. Can't go wrong. You can't start off a video without any coffee or tea beforehand, so I started my day off, or this video, with some coffee. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Bear, and on this channel we are talking about photography, videography, camera talk, talking about a bunch of things, cameras, gear and things like that. So if you want to know more, stick to the end. So today we are going to talk about audio, and not audio in general, but we are going to talk about a microphone I used in the past. So before I go into that, I have two things to say before we start this video. The first thing is, I love all the comments you guys left on the previous camera talk videos, and it really motivates me to make more camera talk videos because I love to make those videos. I love this series. Those are the comments I read. Thank you to all you guys, and I hope you guys love this series. If you want to hear me talk about a specific topic or something you want me to talk about in future videos, let me know in the comments down below. I bought a new desktop arm with my mic attached to it, and I really like this arm because the mic is now really close to my face. Audio needs to be pretty dope from here on out. So let me know in the comments down below if the audio is actually better. Speaking of audio, in today's video we are going to talk about the Rode Video Micro, because that's one of the first microphone I ever used when I started out with content creation. And I actually shot my first vlog, and a vlog I never posted before. I was really impressed by the price and also the quality. So in this video, I'm going to unbox the Rode Video Micro, and I'm going to talk a little bit about what's inside of the box. And after that, I'm going to do two audio tests, show you guys how good this microphone actually is. Make the box appear. So this is the Rode Video Micro. I bought this microphone, and I think the cost of this microphone is between $30 and $80, so it's a really, really cheap microphone. I sold it a couple of months ago for this one, and let's get into it. So inside of the box we have a shoe mount, and the shoe mount is the Rikon shoe mount. It helps the camera to reduce the noise or unwanted noise when you are moving the camera around. So when you are swinging the camera around because you are vlogging, this helps to reduce the noise created by those movements. Second of all, it's just a simple output 3.5mm jack. One end is going into the microphone and the other end is going into the camera. Pretty basic, pretty simple. So my favorite thing of all the microphones are the dead cats. This is not the actual dead cat, like as in actual cat that died, but it's more of a fuzzball, a furry hairy ball. You put it onto your microphone and it helps to reduce unwanted windy noise. This is pretty handy, and a dead cat is always your best friend. When you are shooting outside and you have a microphone, make sure to have your dead cat on you, because if you don't, your audio will be... So the microphone itself is made out of metal, so it's really, really strong and durable. If you drop it, I don't think it will be breaking that easily. That's a plus sign. At the front of the microphone, you have some grills attached to it, or within it, I should say. So the grill side is faced towards the audio source side. So in this case, it's my mouth. When I am vlogging, I have this part of the microphone towards my mouth, so it captures the audio really great. Besides that, the microphone isn't that long, like it fits between my thumb and my middle finger, so it's really, really small. It doesn't add much weight to your already existing setup. One of the plus signs is it doesn't have an external battery, because my main microphone, it has external batteries, so every time when I'm not shooting, I need to charge up my batteries, because if I don't, I can't shoot. This one doesn't have any batteries, so it uses the power of your camera's batteries, so that's also a plus sign. The only downside of this microphone is it doesn't work on every camera. I will list all the cameras over here which doesn't work with this microphone. It's a bummer for those people. We are going into the audio test, the YouTube setup audio test. We are going to test out how the microphone sounds like inside of a YouTube studio. I have my sound panels on the wall and I have one blanket on the floor, so this might affect the result of the audio, but I will be using firstly the built-in microphone of the EOS RP, then I will be using the Rode Video Micro, then I will be using my studio mic, the Rode Video Mic Pro. So with that being said, let's switch over to the inbuilt microphone. This is the inbuilt microphone of the Canon EOS RP, and I won't have this section for long because it sounds horrible and I don't want you guys clicking off of the video. So this is how it sounds like when the microphone is plugged off and the camera records the audio itself. So I have the Rode Video Micro on my boom arm and actually looks really great, so I might keep it that way. This one pure for the quality of the audio, but if you can't afford it or you just want the cheaper version of it, our bad boy over here, the micro, is I think the way to go. This was the first audio test in the YouTube studio. Leave in the comments down below what your thoughts and your opinions are on the Rode Video Micro, how it compares to the other microphones inside of this YouTube studio. So let's go outside and let's see if the Rode Video Micro can handle the noise from the outside world. So let's do some weather report with Beer. Today it's 20 degrees outside, cloudy, so that's why the lighting is a little bit weird right now. It's a little bit windy. I'm recording right now on the Rode Video Mic Pro. Next up I will be shooting on the Rode Video Micro with the dead cat on it. Let's find a good spot to try out the Rode Video Micro. So I haven't switched yet to the Rode Video Micro. I'm going to do that in a little bit. I'm going to test the Rode Video Micro in a calm setting like this one. Without further ado, let's switch over to the Rode Video Micro. So the funny thing is about this microphone, I bought it I think 8 or 10 months ago. I used it for my first ever video gig, my first video job. I bought this microphone 2 days before I had the job, so I didn't have time to practice with it to see if it's actually good, if the quality is okay. So I didn't try it out until I did the job. I went back home, edited the video, and the quality was amazing. Just a non-amateur tip: if you ever have a video gig, make sure you always test your gear before you are going to shoot with it for a client, because you don't want to be that guy that shoots and then eventually the audio or the visuals aren't top-notch, top quality as you promised them. So that's really important. If I need to give you some advice, don't ever use gear for the first time when you are shooting for a client. Yeah, with that being said, let's test this bad boy out in a more busy environment. So let's look up for some traffic. So we are at the place right now where it's much more traffic. There are two roadways over here, so there must be a lot more traffic. No idea, because I never tested it before, how this microphone performs under too much noise. I think it does a decent job, and I have to say, this is a crowded place. There are driving a lot of cars. We have to test it to the maximum to give you guys a good understanding and perspective on how this microphone actually works. Can't decide right now if it is good or not, so you guys can leave in the comments down below what you think, how this microphone performs outside with a lot of noise. I'm going back home right now. I'm going to listen to the audio. So I'm back on the Rode Video Mic Pro, and I didn't even ask you guys this question, but what type of microphone do you guys use? Do you guys use a Rode microphone, or do you guys use any other microphone? Let me know in the comments down below. I will see you guys in the YouTube studio. So I listened to the audio to give you guys my last thoughts on the Rode Video Micro. Let's get into it. The only differences I could find in the audio test compared to the other microphones we used is the bass. The bass on the Rode Video Micro isn't the best. It's not bad or anything, but it isn't the best. You can always edit the bass levels in your Premiere Pros, in your Final Cut Pros, in your DaVinci. I think it's not a huge deal breaker, but it is something worth pointing out. So the Rode Video Micro did a pretty decent job in the studio setup, in my opinion. So it could be used for a studio setup. You can use this microphone also for vlogging. So let me know in the comments down below if you think the same or if you think something else, and what you think about the Rode Video Micro. With that being said, if you got some value out of this video, make sure to smash that like button. Leave a comment down below what you thought about the video. I'll see you guys in the next video.